I'm with you on that, Cody.
All right, bro. This is a question that I like to ask all our guests as well. If you had to have a superpower, which one would you pick?
Teleportation.
Teleporting. Okay. We've had that one before, Cody.
Easy, that's quick. Boom. In and out. Yeah. You do whatever you want.
Just, anyway. I guess because I like traveling. To Italy quick.
Quick. Like the movie Jumper, where they could teleport. Oh, yeah. Jumper.
Yeah.
I'd be anywhere and everywhere.
That's crazy. So speaking of movies, bro, question three is, what's your favorite movie all time, bro? Matter of fact, give me top two. Give me top two.
All right, does a franchise count, or you want like solo movie?
You can get solo movie. Nah, we want solo.
Star Wars: Revenge of the Sith, the third one. That's probably my all time fave. I'm a Star Wars fanatic.
Of course, because they're in space, they're fighting, they're doing all this stuff in space. That's why you like Star Wars, bro. It makes perfect sense.
It makes so much sense, right?
And I do not see myself ever going to space. I'm too big for spaceships. I'm claustrophobic. I don't like Star Wars. It makes perfect sense, bro.
Hey, we're on the same page. That's respectable. That's a respectable explanation. We're on the same page. I love Star Wars. And I like Avengers. I like the superhero movies. Avengers is my favorite.
Yeah, I like how Marvel puts the story. Like, they'll come out with a random movie and they'll connect it in some type of way. You know, it's like they'll come out, like, just thinking back to all the old Marvels and the Captain America, the one where he was at war, and all those, like, they always found a way to connect it. And even still now with the Black Panther and stuff like that, it's all connected. That's what I like about Marvel most.
Yeah, no, I'm with you.
What are yours, Will? You never told us what your favorite movies are.
All right, so I guess I'll give you a top three. My favorite movie, by far, All About the Benjamins.
Okay.
That's probably my favorite movie.
Book them.
Second and third, they're both going to be Will Smith movies because that's my favorite actors, if y'all want to know that question too. But I have to say Hancock and I Am Legend.
I was about to say Hancock. I love that movie.
Freaking Hancock and I Am Legend, bro. Both two amazing movies. Of course, I'm kind of biased being that Will Smith my favorite actor, but
I'm with you.
I'm pretty sure almost anybody would attest that they're really good movies, though. What about you, though, Kobe? Cody, get us what's your favorite? Your top three movies?
I would say number one is my number one movie is Next Friday. Like, I can quote that movie like all the way through. That's my favorite.
You always quoting it around my career.
I'll actually tell you a movie that I just saw that I thought was pretty good. It's called The Irishman.
Okay.
That was pretty good. I watched that one and Parasite.
That John crazy.
I heard Parasite was good. I haven't seen it.
Yeah, it's just kind of annoying. You got to read all the things, but it is a dope ending to it, though.
But I like the Avengers Endgame movie. I thought that was a pretty good movie.
Mm-hmm.
I like the first one because the villain won.
Mm-hmm.
And like, it was so, like, they gave you every single opportunity to see the hero win. And you're like, oh, they're going to win. They're going to do it. They're going to do it. And they just kept crushing your soul.
Yeah.
To the end, you're like, oh.
And then they come out with Endgame, and I see him die right in the beginning. And I'm like,
what the
heck? Like, I know it's not about to be this easy. Like,
I was like, it's over?
Yeah.
They did a really good job.
Yeah,
it was a really good job playing them together.
Absolutely.
Yo, so I went to see, I saw Avengers. I saw Captain Marvel, like, the 3 o'clock shift, and then walked across the hallway straight into Endgame.
Yeah.
So I watched like 6 straight hours of Marvel movies.
You need to plead the fifth, bro. you got to plead the fifth, Josh.
Yeah.
But all right, question four, bro. What's your celebrity crush, bro, all time? You got to give us somebody.
Zendaya.
Zendaya?
Yo.
Zendaya.
That's your boy right there, Cody.
It's crazy, yo. We were coming out of Target.
You can't have a crush on Zendaya. She's my crush, okay?
We don't have to share, Josh.
He said we go share. Say, y'all willing to share?
Yo, like, Will and I were just having this conversation coming out of Target the other day. Like, this girl looked just like Zendaya. And Will didn't know who I was talking about at first.
Yeah, I did.
Will,
I
you're tripping. On,
yeah, I know now, though. I know.
Will, you are tripping.
I know.
Well, I mean, obviously she's gorgeous, but I think like she's dope. Like, you can see that she uses her platform for so much, just like how, especially like now, like She's doing so much, whether it's women's equality, whether it's racial equality, no matter what it is, like she's always out there in the streets grinding and supporting the people. So
yeah,
nothing to crush. I'll claim her.
That role she played in Euphoria was different too. Like I wasn't expecting.
Yeah, that was impressive. I was impressed. She's talented. She's very talented. That was. I'm tuned in to season two whenever it drops.
Facts.
Yeah. All right, bro.
Big facts.
Final question of the final five for you right here, Josh, bro. Who was your favorite football team before entering the NFL?
Growing up in Atlanta, I was a Falcons fan. Grew up in the Mike Vick age. So I obviously was a Mike Vick fan, had the jersey. I enjoyed watching like Donovan McNabb as well growing up in Philly. Okay. But we would go to Falcons games quite a bit, actually. So I always enjoy getting down, seeing the Dirty Birds, you know.
That's dope, bro. That's dope. Yeah, I actually always grew up a Green Bay Packers fan, for whoever didn't know it. Diehard Packers
fan. What made you a Packers fan?
Bro, I've always been a fan.
Favre fan?
Favre, bro. That's all I was going to say. I've always been a Brett Favre fan. And then, like, but I've always been a person, too. Even if I like a person, I'm going to always like the team over just the person itself. So, like with Kobe, yeah. Always been a Kobe fan. Like, you know what I'm saying? Of course, he stayed with the Lakers the whole time. But, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm still going to always be a Laker fan, no matter what. But, Yeah, Brett Favre was my guy, bro. He was just what got me the most about Brett Favre, especially being as a child, he was just a warrior, bro. Like, he'd fight through any pain that he could, you know. He would go out there. He's the one person that he'll go out there. He'll try to go out there with a torn rotator cuff and try to play, you know, like
he's playing. He's
like a trooper. That, bro. He had the dog in him, bro. And that's what really got Brett. But bro, so that's pretty much it. Josh, bro, we truly appreciate you coming onto the podcast, bro. We appreciate your time, bro. It's always good to, like, not only hear from a brother of mine, a teammate of mine, but a scientist, astrophysicist. You know, he's the guy. You're just the overall good guy, bro. And we truly just appreciate your time, bro, for coming on with us.
Appreciate it. Yeah. Thank you guys for having me.
For real, man. And we can definitely link up for the fourth this weekend, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do something.
And also
– socially distant, of course.
And like I warned you before we even started the pod, we asked this at the end of every show, who should we get on the sideline story next? But before you even say it, bro, you got to try to get us Juju, bro. You got to try to get us Juju, bro. Talk to him, bro. See what he'll do, bro. But if not that, bro, what would be a suggestion on somebody that you would like to see on the pod or could help us with getting on the pod?
Yeah, I think Juju would be dope. So we can see what we can do. Him or either even staying in the house. I think a cool one to hear someone's perspective is like Chris Conley, who made it to NFL and started playing football in high school. Didn't play football that long, and now has been in the league. Has had a long 10 years. Really, really involved in a lot of the movements that are going on today. So can really touch on that. And then also like loves gaming. Active streamer.
Taven.
He's so multifaceted. I think he'll be a cool one to kind of pick his brain on as well.
Oh, I thought you were about to say Taven. I thought you was about, when you were saying gamer, the first thing that came to my mind, I thought you were about to say Taven too. I was about to say, I'm definitely going to try to get Taven on.
Taven will be interesting too. Who knows?
Taven would be a very interesting conversation on here, bro.
Yes. Yes, sure, it would. Bro.
Oh, yeah. Once again, it's just an honor just to have Josh on. I met Josh last, I met Josh my rookie year coming into the NFL, and I met him out in Vegas. He came out to Vegas with a guy that was on our offensive line my rookie year, and he met them out there, and I met Josh out there. But I truly got to meet Josh this season when he came to the Jaguars. And you're talking about an extremely amazing person, not just an athlete, but just super smart, just amazing person to get along with, and truly, truly cares about his family and just everybody who surrounds him. Definitely one of the quarterbacks in the league that I say I give a lot of respect to, both on and off the field, for what he's done.
Not to mention, we just had the smartest guy in the NFL, like the smartest. An actual rocket scientist was just on our podcast. And if you don't know much about Josh Dobbs, Google him. Yep. And it's deeper than football. Phenomenal football player. And I think the Jags have now, they got the smartest quarterback room in the NFL, because I think Minshew had the highest Wonderlic score. He had like a perfect score. So those two in the same room, it's crazy. But Dobbs, just overall, man, the few times I've met him, great guy, humble, down to earth, and just easy to talk to, man. A guy who's very, very multifaceted, deeper than he's got a lot more to him than just football, you know? And we appreciate him coming on, giving us some perspective from NASA and some of the things going on in the world right now. And just truly thankful for the opportunity to have a conversation and chop it up with Josh Dobbs.
For sure. Once again, we appreciate everybody for viewing the Sideline Story. Once again, you can go and follow us on any of the social media platforms, as well as follow us on Spotify Music, Spotify Podcasts, as well as Apple Podcasts and iHeartRadio.
Yep. Rate and subscribe, review, hit us up with feedback. We thank everybody for their support. You know, this thing's starting to grow and couldn't do it without our fans. And once again, we just thank you for tuning in. Thank you for listening to us and taking our insight.
And once again, thank you for listening to the Sideline Story.
And we out. Nobody tell me what I ain't gonna be no more. You're thinking I'm a fall, don't be so sure. I wish somebody made guidelines on how to get up off the sideline.